Hello friends, welcome back to next one. In this session, we are going to discuss how to convert our user credential into Base64 encoded or decoded format. Let's take an example of WhatsApp. So WhatsApp is decrypting or encrypting your text message, whatever you are sending to your friends. So in real life also, whatever user credential or highly confidential data, what generally architect or developer has developed the logic, they are simply converting into the Base64 or other format. So for example, let's say I am logging into my application and I have to pass username and password. So in username and password, I am passing as a plain text, but they have written the logic like that they are converting into a Base64 format. So how it works and how we can deal with our framework. So for example, this is my username and password, so which is admin and admin 123. So to convert Base64, before that we need to understand what is Base64. So Base64 is a group of binary to text encoding scheme that represent binary data into ASCII string format. So let's take an example. Let's say my username is admin and my password is admin 123. So this is how I have written here. Now I am encoding it. So like this, in this format, developers are sending data from front end to back end to avoid security issues. So now we'll see how we can do using Java code. So here I am going to my Java utils class and I am going to create one method, public void base64 encode. In try catch block, what I am going, first I am initializing my username and password. So my username will be, and this method is going to consume two values, which is username and password. So I am writing final string username and final string password. So this will be considered as a my entire login credential. So it will be string cred is equal to username plus password. Username, let's say you are concatenating within some operator or some random data, so you need to write here username and password. So now your entire value will be admin:admin123. So now this string we have to convert into base64. So what I am going to do, cred is equal to base64. So I have to write base64, which comes inside the java.util.getencoder. So suppose you want to decode, then you have to use get decoder, otherwise you have to encode. Here we are going to encode because we have encoded. So we are sending data into encoded format. So get encoder dot encode to string, and we have to pass our credential. So credential dot get bytes. So first we need to convert into bytes, as it is explained here, binary data into ASCII string. So we have to this credential, we need to first convert it into bytes, and then it is going to convert into base64 format, and this string value is going to return me a encoded data. So let me, I am going to print this sysout and cred. So this method will work. So now let me test this. I am going to create a main method here, and I have to create the object of this class to call that method, utils is equal to java utils, and using this utils reference I am calling that method utils.base64. So I have to pass our credential. So my credential will be admin 123, and we have to throw an exception because, so this method is going to, this line is going to convert my admin and admin 123 into base encoded format. So let me run this class Java application. Yeah, so we are getting the exact same value, whatever we are getting using encoder. Yeah, so if we are going to match this, both the values are similar. Now the thing is how we are going to use in our framework. So for that, let me create one Pojo class here. In our Pojo package, what I'm going to create? I'm going to create a one class which is get credentials. Get or credential Pojo. Credential, and inside I am getting the credentials. So private string and credentials. Now I am going to create a getter and setter for this. So simply we need to right click source and need to generate getters and setters. So using this field, I am going to generate getters and setter. So this is all done. It will be this dot credentials. Done. Now we have to call this Pojo here, there. So let me again go to the Java utils. I am going to make this as a static and I am returning my credential. So I am set. Using this method, I have to set the credential and I have to import this and I have to add a return type here. So I need to add return type. So what this method will return me. So first what I am going to do, I am going to create an object of this class credentials login cred is equal to credentials, and then login cred dot set credential, and I have to set as a, I have to pass as a cred. So using this method, I am going to set the credential and it will return me a return as a login credential. So return login cred. So now we have created. So using this method, it is going to set in that Pojo class. So using this credential, it is going to set inside the Pojo class. Now let's say we are going to test this method. So how it works? So for this, let me create a one login test class. And inside this, I am going to create one test method. Test public void login test. So here our objective is to verify that end-to-end flow is working or not. We need to call this credential Pojo. So credentials, credential login cred, and we need to import this Java utils dot base 64. So here we need to pass our username and password. So my username is admin and my password is, let's say, admin 123, and this method is going to return me a base 64 value. So let's say I'm going to print this login cred. And let me run this. Yes, so this method is going to return me a encoded data, the same data whatever we are getting here. Thank you guys, thanks for the watching this video.